Welcome to the first video of the year 2020. We are in the future now, and for this video I want to share some of my recent sounds with you. And it's this cello sound from one of my last videos, and I actually got asked a lot about the sound, so here we are. I want to share it with you. And this sound is actually available now in my store for $1. Or if you are a Patreon supporter, you get it for free. So that's just for the information in the start. Yeah, let's start the video and I'll show you how it sounds and what you can do with it. If you want to save some money on Bitwig Studio and the upgrade plans, and you want to support my channel and my content, then go to my webpage, use the link to the Bitwig store, use my code and save 10% on the regular price. So here we are on Bitwig Studio 3.1.1, and you actually need exactly this version because my preset makes use of the new vocoder, and the new vocoder is only available with the new release of 3.1.1. So you need this version, just keep that in mind. And when you buy my package or download my package, you actually also get this project here, which you heard in the beginning of the video. And you just can use this to play it back and see how the cello can sound, or maybe you want to extend it, or maybe you just want to see how I use the dynamics here, or the expression modulation. As you can see, there's a lot of modulation going on here. And in this last track here, I have actually a new cello preset loaded up, so I can show you how all these knobs work. So for instance here, the first knob is the expression knob or parameter, and you can use also the mod wheel on your keyboard to change the expression setting. And this expression setting is very important for very dynamic sounds or some string instruments where you want to express this sound better. So you also can use your controller knobs on your keyboard, but for this expression setting here, you can also use the mod wheel if you are used to that. So then we have the second remote control here, which is a vibrato, and this controls the speed of the amplitude modulation. So you can change this with this setting. Then we have the room information here, which is just a Bitwig rework with just this very short decay time and a small room setting. And of course, a very long reverb if you want to have some pad sounds. Or if you want it completely dry. Then you can change the pitch here. If you want to simulate some, if you slide around the fret on the cello actually. Then we have a glide time. But it sounds sometimes too artificial, but maybe you want this. Then there's a cutoff, and this is actually a low pass, but the low pass is not on the on the output, it's more on the modulator sound here. There on the noise I used as a modulator, there's the low pass, and this actually changes the sound a bit differently. So you have still a bit of noise in the high end, as you can see here. We change basically the modulator sound, which is the green information bars here, but the output is still happening above this cutoff frequency. Okay, and then we have output control, and that's all. So we have 8 remote controls here for the cello sound, and of course, if you want to have a more realistic sound, then maybe this is not the right preset. It still sounds like a synth generated sound, but sometimes it's maybe exactly what you want, and you can also, as you saw, can extend it into a pad sound, something like this, and maybe it's exactly the right sound for your dubstep song. I don't know. Sometimes you need just some synthesized cello sounds. So this is this preset here. As I said, it's available in my shop for $1. For my Patreons, it's free, available for free. You can go to my Patreon page and just download it there. And it's also pretty small, some kilobytes. So basically a no-brainer. So thanks for watching this video. Hope it's useful for some of you, and see you in the next video. Thanks for watching, and bye.